accident looks like it's straight out of the movies, and police in North Huntingdon say this is what a man used to try to disguise himself to try to pull off a bank robbery. The alleged wannabe robber's plan led to lockdowns at two high schools this morning and ultimately ended with the masked man in handcuffs. Megan Schiller joins us live from Westmoreland County with how his alleged heist was foiled.
Susan, police had surveillance video. They knew, or at least they thought they knew, who they were looking for. But after they started talking to the suspect for a little bit, they noticed that something was up. A viewer sent us video of the arrest, so take a look. A viewer sent KDKA this cell phone video showing North Huntingdon officers arresting the suspect, Luke Dell. Even in this video, shot from a distance, he appears to be a middle-aged man. Luke, do you have anything to say?
I'm very sorry.
Here's Dell hours later, looking about 30 years younger.
The mask was a very high-quality mask. Made him look like he was probably in his late 60s, early 70s, when in fact he was a 35-year-old male.
Chief Robert Rizzo said Dell put on this expensive, lifelike mask to carry out his alleged diversion plan that started here.
A gentleman walked into the local Bob Evans, a note was passed, and the notes, there were threats to Norman High School and Jeanette High School with bombs and active shooter.
That prompted lockdowns. High schoolers sent home early and bomb-sniffing dogs that turned up nothing.
It was a smart plan, but I don't think it was that intelligent to involve the kids, because he's going to get in a lot more trouble because of that.
Detectives tracked Dell's car and made the arrest, but they found no weapons. They said his reason for the threats and the mask?
Pull all the resources to one area, and then his intent was to possibly rob a bank. That's what he wanted to do. He never followed through with that intent.
And another interesting thing is that Dell isn't even from here. He's from Beaver Creek, Ohio. They say he was in the area for another reason, but according to the paperwork released by police, they say he's going to be charged with terroristic threats, causing or risking catastrophe, reckless threat to use a weapon of mass destruction, and theft of a license plate. Reporting live outside the North Huntingdon Police Department, I'm Megan Schiller, Katie Kane.
Movies, the agents wear realistic face masks as disguises to trick their enemies. In real life, mask technology has advanced so much that those made-up storylines aren't so impossible to imagine anymore. Joining us now with more is Rob Jenkins. He's a psychologist and researcher at the University of York in England. Okay, I know I'm supposed to be talking to Rob, but you look like Walter White.
Yeah, I'm in here somewhere, but you know, I'm getting too old for this kind of thing.
This is... Look at this. Come on.
Here we go.
What? I mean, that's just... I'm just floored by how realistic it looked. That's incredible.
Yeah, well, we've kept finding that in live situations, people just accept these masks as real faces. So we've set up a computer-based test to find out just how realistic they are. And the test is very simple. We just show people pairs of photographs. One is always a real face, the other is always a mask. And the task is simply to indicate which one is the mask. Now, if people can tell the difference, they should pick the mask every time, but that's not what we found. In fact, people pick the real face instead of the mask on at least 20% of occasions. So
wow.
This tells us that people are having a really tough time telling the best of these masks from real faces.
Well, these incredibly lifelike masks, and I've got one right here. They're made by a Quebec-based company, Real Flesh Masks, and they're designed, as you said, to imitate real human faces. And they really do. They look remarkably real. So we've got a picture of an actual human face, and here is one of a realistic mask. So as you said, you did this research, and you asked participants to choose between the masks and the wearing of the faces. Were you surprised by what you discovered?
We were surprised because some people are skeptical and tend to be overconfident, saying, oh, well, I would be able to tell the difference. We don't have to argue about that. We can just run the experiment. And so that's what we've done.
These masks are designed to be used for a variety of reasons, medical training, movie production. There have got to be some current concerns, some practical concerns about how they could be used outside of those purposes.
Well, we're interested in how people cover their faces to conceal their identity. And if someone robs a bank, say, wearing a balaclava, then police will be fully aware that they don't know what the robber looks like. But if someone robs a bank wearing a mask that passes for human, then they might think they know what the robber looks like, but be very much mistaken. And that can lead the investigation down the wrong path if they're looking for someone of the wrong age or the wrong race or the wrong gender. And that's not just hypothetical. We're aware of about 40 cases worldwide where something for other cues that conflict with the signal you're getting from the face. There could be mismatches in apparent age. So if the way the person is moving looks very youthful, but the face looks very old and wrinkled and haggard, that's a useful mismatching cue. So there are a number of things that you could look for that are not directly to do with facial appearance, but exploit the facial appearance in conjunction with other messages that you're getting.
But there's one last thing. Let's just see who you really are, mister.
Why, it's old man Withers, the guy who runs the haunted amusement park.
And I would have got away with it, too, if it hadn't been for you snooping kids.
Good one, Shaggy.
Excellent, Scoop.